welcome back to my channel. Today I'm really excited because I'm going to be telling you all about a new readathon that I am taking part in. Now I absolutely love reading. I have always loved reading ever since I was a child. However, I don't always have the time to read as much as I'd like to, which makes me really sad, but really excited that I get to participate in the Reading Rush 2020. The Reading Rush is a week-long readathon which is hosted by booktuber Ariel Bassett and former booktuber Raylene LeMay. The readathon takes place every year and is free for readers worldwide. Now this is the first time I'm going to be doing it, and I'm going to be doing it with one of my best friends, Kaylee. She has a podcast called Ladies in Literature. I'm going to be co-hosting a special edition podcast which you will be able to listen to in the description below. We're going to be talking about everything that we've read and done and our opinions and what's been happening over the readathon. But I'm also going to be vlogging and putting out at the end of the week a reading vlog of how I found this challenge. So I'm going to get straight into my to be read list. Now there are 7 prompts which I am just going to quickly read off so I don't forget what they are. First prompt is to read a book with a cover that matches the colour of your birthstone. The second is to read a book that starts with the word the. The third is a book that has inspired a movie you've already seen. To read the first book that you touch, read a book completely outside of your house, to read a book in a genre that you've always wanted to read more of, and to read a book that takes place on a different continent to where you live. I have managed to pick 3 books that cover all 7 prompts. Now this is not only because it's going to make it easier for me and I will be able to put more focus on those books, but I'm also doing some more vlogging next week. There's going to be 2 vlogs coming out to you next week. On Friday I'm going to be releasing a One Direction 10 year anniversary reaction video. So what's been happening, what's been said, you know, it's just going to kind of, I'm not really sure exactly what's going to entail yet, but it's going to be all focused on what happens with the 10 year anniversary of One Direction. So this will allow me to be able to vlog both. But I'll be giving you more information about the One Direction vlog as it comes out. Let's go on and see what's on my to-be-read list. The first book I have decided to read is The Kingdom by Jess Rothenberg. This covers the prompts, the colour of my birthstone. So my birthday is in June and this is the colour of my birthstone.
This book also covers the prompt to read a book starting with the word the.
It was also the first book I touched, so I have a bookshelf over there and I put all the books that had the on them and I closed my eyes and touched it, and this is the one that I picked, and I'm gonna read this one completely outside of my house. So by outside, because obviously we're still in lockdown but we can go out, I'm gonna try reading in the garden and in the park. It generally just depends. I am gonna try and do it outside of my house, but if the weather doesn't hold up or we go back into lockdown or anything happens, then I will be reading this book indoors by a window or listening to outdoor sounds, something like that. We'll work it out as we go along. The second book I'm going to be reading is Northern Lights by Philip Pullman. Now, I'm obsessed with his Dark Materials. I absolutely love the TV programme and I absolutely love the film The Golden Compass. I started to read this and it's really good. I just didn't have a chance to finish it, and I feel like I might have read it when I was younger, but honestly I can't remember much. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to read this book. It's going to be for prompt number 3, which is to read a book inspired by a movie, but also prompt number 7, which is that it takes place on a different continent. Now I know that some of it is set in Oxford and London, but they do go to the north, and I'm counting the North as a different continent because I really want to read this book. This is the first book in the His Dark Materials trilogy and I'm so excited to read it. I feel like I've probably read it, but I can't really remember, so I'm gonna read it. Yes, that's that book. And my final book for the prompt, which is prompt number 6, which is a book in a genre you want to read more, is going to be Sabrina the Teenage Witch. Now, Kaylee got this for me. This was even my birthday present this year, or it was my Christmas present last year, I can't remember. But she got me this book for my birthday and I'm so excited, and I don't read a lot of graphic novels. I used to read comics and some graphic novels when I was younger, but I haven't read them for many years and I really do want to read more, and this looks really exciting, especially as I'm obsessed with The Chilling Adventures of Sabrina. It's so good, and I did like Sabrina the Teenage Witch, but I definitely preferred The Chilling Adventures of Sabrina. So I'm really excited to be reading this. This is on my to be read list, but it's not on my for my reading rush. If I get around to doing it, that'll be great. If not, it doesn't matter. I'll read it at another point. If I manage to finish all those books, I've got this book called The Devouring Grey. Now, we saw this at Comic-Con last year, and Kayla got this for me for my birthday this year, and I'd really like to read it. Also, it's the colour of my birthstone, or it's close enough to the colour of my birthstone, and begins with the. So if I do finish, then I can also read this one. The blurb for this book is, on the edge of town, a beast haunts the woods, trapped in the grey, its bonds loosening. Uprooted from the city, Violet Saunders doesn't have much hope for fitting in at her new school in Four Paths, a town almost buried in woodlands and something very like fear. When she meets Justin, May, Isaac and Harper, all children of the founder's families, and sees the otherworldly destruction they can wreak, she starts to wonder if the townsfolk are right to be afraid. When the bodies start to appear in the woods, the locals become downright hostile. Can the teenagers solve the mystery of the Four Paths and their own part in it before calamity strikes? This just looks so good. So if I do manage to read these and I have time, then I would like really like to read this book. It sounds so good, and I remember seeing it at Comic-Con at Yolk last year and absolutely falling in love with it. So I'm really excited to read that as well. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Comment below if you're going to be participating in the Reading Rush 2020, what's on your reading list, or if you were to participate, what would you put on your reading list? If you would like to subscribe, click here. And if you'd like to see any of my other videos, click here. I hope you're having the most magical day. Stay safe, and I shall see you soon. Bye!